Hey, what is up, guys? My name is Arcus1426. Welcome back to another episode of my walkthrough for Noire. We're probably about to finish up the second case and moving on to the third one, which is called A House of Sticks. We're about to investigate Chapman's car, and then we'll see what happens after that. Anyways, hope you all enjoying the series. If you are, smash the like button. If you want to see more like this, be sure you subscribe to the channel. Hope we get to 450 subs. I appreciate it. And don't forget to put notifications on so you don't miss any new videos or uploads I do in the future. And without further ado, let's get it.
Let's see what he's hauling around. Motive, opportunity, and hard evidence. We should revise the APB. He's clearly armed. Definitely gives him opportunity.
Holy crap. There he is. It's Chap. He's coming out of the laundromat. Shit. He's seen us.
Cops. Again.
Son of a bitch. He must have caught the trolley. We gotta move fast, Cole. I'll call this in, get some cars dispatched. Car 11K calling KGPL.
Go ahead, 11K.
11K requesting assistance. In pursuit of suspect aboard the 1110 University streetcar, currently heading east on Melrose Avenue. Advise all units. Suspect is in control of car and driving dangerously.
Come on.
Stay on his ass, Cole. Don't lose him.
Yeah, I got him. I'm trying to... shit. Did my cat just unplug my sound? No, we're good. Oh my gosh.
See if he can damage one of the wheels. Might act like a brake and slow the thing down. Hold him tight, Cole. As soon as he ditches the tram, we'll be there to grab him.
Stop biting, you two.
Get me closer to the driver's cabin. I'll plug Chapman. I can't hit a target that isn't there, Phelps.
Oh.
Look, Cole, the side plate's gone. Get me closer. I think I got a shot here.
Shoot the wheel. Shoot the wheel. Yeah.
End of the line, you little prick. Come on, Cole. Like we have our man, Cole. Well done.
I'm not so sure. Chapman seemed to have his own agenda. There seems to be more to this than a personal vendetta.
What are you talking about?
The fires benefit Elysian in some way. I see Chapman and Monroe working together.
You have a point. The evidence is good for Chapman. Hard to be worrying about his side of the story when he's blasting away with that big 45.
Nice work, gentlemen. Put yourself at considerable risk stopping that trolley and probably saved a lot of lives. Anyone else but you, Phelps, and you'd be up for a bravery award. We've had our eyes on that slippery son of a bitch Chapman for as long as I can remember. Couldn't be happier than to wipe him off the scoreboard. I hope this puts to bed that crazy stuff you had going about Leland Monroe. What were you thinking, Phelps? calling Richard Nixon a crook next.
What is it?
A letter from Lou. His insurance policy named me beneficiary.
California Fire and Life. You worked for Elysian?
The roof that he was working on collapsed.
It's a very generous settlement. Elsa, I'd like you to do something for me. I think there's something dirty about Elysian Fields.
What has that got to do with Lou?
I want you to reject this settlement. I want you to go and see an investigator named Jack Kelso and ask him to make some inquiries about Lou's case.
Isn't this police work?
You want to find out what happened to Lou?
Why would he help Miss Kelso?
Jack won't be able to help himself if he smells a rat.
He's a friend of yours?
He hates my guts. Elsa, you take this money and let them get away with it, or we could get Jack's help and do something about it.
Why not be honest with this man, Cole? He deserves your honesty if you want his help.
Believe me, Elsa, I'd like to level with him. Really would, but it's too late. Years too late.
Why did I only get 4 stars?
Mr. Kelso?
That's what the sign on the door says, miss.
Whoa! Am I playing as Jack?
There's no need to come into the office, Ms. Lichtman. If you accept the settlement, all you need to do is sign here.
I don't accept the settlement.
What do you mean you don't accept? I think you're pushing your luck, lady. This seems to be a ridiculously generous settlement. A $200 policy with a $20,000 payout? You should...
I don't want the money.
What do you mean you don't want the money?
I want you to investigate this case. I feel my friend may have been the victim of foul play.
Okay, let me get the case file.
There's got to be more in these files.
Sounds like your friend took a hell of a fall. I'm sorry for your loss.
Nope. Okay. I guess I can't. I can't believe I'm playing as Jack Kelso right now, though.
Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Of course not.
What basis do you have for your claim of foul play?
Lou Buckwalter was a craftsman. I don't believe he would have made a roof that would collapse.
Okay.
You want me to reopen this case based on your woman's intuition? That isn't going to happen. Take the...
Revolse, if you want to watch, I am, I'm Jack now. I'm Jack now.
Oh, you're almost done.
Why am I Jack?
Jack Kelso. Change the thing.
Hold up.
I do
fuck.
Share the thing.
Oh, hold up. Mute yourself.
You and Buckwalter weren't married?
No.
Then how did you become his beneficiary?
We were family friends.
Okay, eyes are going down. Okay, come on.
You expect me to reopen this case because you come in here walking that walk? Well, I'm not buying it. I think you should tell me what the hell is going on.
You really want to know?
Yes.
We were interned together on Ellis Island, resident alien Germans whose parents had been killed by Nazis. You see the irony in that, Mr. Kelso. We spent 4 years there.
So the roof collapsed. Accidents happened. What exactly are you trying to achieve here, Ms. Lichtman?
Exactly what I said. I want that building thoroughly investigated.
Straight face, to the point. Not looking sideways. Okay.
I'm intrigued, Miss Lichtman. I really am. But you're going to have to give me something if you want me to get involved in this.
There is a conspiracy surrounding Elysian Fields and the new houses they are building. I believe your insurance company is involved.
That's pretty heady stuff, Miss Lichtman. Flimsy, but heady.
I've told you what I know, Mr. Kelso. What are you going to do about it?
All right, Ms. Lichtman. One final question.
Yes.
What's your address?
Is that usual?
Is there anything usual about this case, Ms. Lichtman?
The address is on the letter, Mr. Kelso.
The address? Not the phone number.
Hmm.
Mr. Benson would like to see you in his office, Jack. Upstairs. Come on, I'll walk you up.
Oh, please tell me he's not starting to fall for her too. No, no, no.
You know
what I mean? No. No, it was bad enough that Colt messed up. I cannot believe
it's that German horror, bro.
Is he really? No!
Yeah, bro.
No! That's why you want the phone number, bro.
Who doesn't like porking a German?
Oh my gosh, no.
You could salute the Nazis. Nine!
I mean, at least he won't get in trouble. Although, might get into a fight with Cole.
Mr. Benson? You wanted to see me?
Oh, yes, Jack. I'm just trying out.
Oh, you're gonna hate that guy.
I noticed Elsa Lichtman in the lobby.
It's the weirdest thing, Mr. Benson.
Call me Curtis, Jack. This is California.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Like I said, Curtis.
You're gonna hate that guy.
This is a very strange case.
Sorry for the voice crack.
How so, Jack?
That lady, Elsa Lichtman, is refusing a 20 grand payout.
Elsa Lichtman is hardly a lady, Jack. She's a jazz musician. Plays at the Blue Room in Hollywood. She has a fine pair of lungs, now that I think
she's
of
the beneficiary of this guy, Lou Buckwalter. He was killed in an industrial accident working for Elysian Fields Developments. You know Elysian?
I'm familiar with Leland Monroe. We move in similar circles.
Well, Ms. Lichtman is making some pretty serious accusations. She says the case stinks and that
she's a very highly strung girl, Jack. Strung out might be a better way to put it.
It's a pretty generous payment, Curtis. I think I should look into
it. Is there anything wrong with the paperwork, Kelso?
No, there isn't, Mr. Benson.
I didn't think so. Pay the case out and get her off our backs.
I can't make her take the money,
Deal
sir.
With it, Jack! Do your fucking job! Do I have to do everything?
No, sir, you don't.
Fine, Jack. Fine.
I guess it would make sense that Jack's going after it since Cole was told to back off of it. Oh, good lord.
What the hell?
Your car, Mr. Kelso.
Oh, thank you. Yay, I got no partner, bitches. I'm on my own. Oh my word. I could go crash into people whatever I want and no one's gonna comment on my driving. Okay, Jack, what are you listening to? No. Copyright music, bro. Good lord. Why is everything so far away?
Hey!
I went down the wrong street. Don't mind me, I'm just driving through people's lawns. Don't mind me. Driving through the road, driving through the sidewalk. Tight turns. I have no idea what the hell you just said.
That's not how my pop taught me to mix it. Someone is cutting corners.
You hear that?
But
cutting corners.
Girl, if you're gonna you gotta mute yourself, bud.
Okay, I'll mute myself.
You can watch, but you gotta mute yourself.
Bulldozing starting again. Leland Monroe. The man with the grin. Looks like he doesn't like to be disappointed.
Hey!
Oh, shit.
You can't be walking around down here.
I'm Jack Kelso, from California Fire and Life.
I don't care if you're from the Vatican. Buzz off!
I'm investigating the accidental death of a Lou Buckwalter, and...
You deaf? Do I have to beat on you?
Looks like you do.
Oh my gosh! Oh shit. Come on, Jack. Throw them fists. Come on. You lost your hat. Come on. You know what happens when you lose your hat.
I came to see the house where Lou Buckwalter died. You were just about to offer to show me the way.
It's out the gate, three houses down to the left.
Where'd the revolve go?
Oh, he's still here.
For smart guy. There's nothing there.
Then I'll poke around in the rubble.
Fine. As long as you're out of my sight.
Damn, can I pick my hat back up? I can! I didn't know you could pick your hat back up this entire game, bro. I'm so confused. What is this music? It's copyright, that's what it is. Why am I here?
The place falls. And then they bulldoze it. What gives here?
Try to piece this together.
Okay.
That's not right.
Nope. Keystone. It's Keystone. This one.
Keystone Films. Who gets their lumber from a film studio?
So it's fake wood, huh? Oh shit. Oh, run, Indiana Jones, run!
Bitch!
Oh shit! It's over! I have the high ground!
Oh shit!
Oh fuck.
Come on, Jack.
Sorry, pal.
Yeah!
I thought we were starting to get on.
Ha ha! The power of Dr. Jones prevails again.
Jack Kelso, California Fire and Life Investigator. I need an address on the Keystone Film Company.
The address is 658 North Wilton Place. Is there anything else?
No, thank you, ma'am.
You know, I'm not gonna lie, I kinda like Jack better than Cole.
That doesn't even make any sense. You barely played with Jack.
But he seems so badass.
They're both badass.
The man just outran a boulder. You don't see Cole doing that.
Cole's done better than that.
Jack was more active in the war, though.
With affiliates,
I don't know about
Los
that.
Angeles, California,
they're both pretty active.
New York, and Milwaukee, Wisconsin. This is American Century.
By the way, are you finishing this game tonight?
I'm gonna try to.
You got work, right?
Yeah.
You got some flow?
Yep.
Alright, just play this. Finish the game. We don't have to play tonight. Like, I kind of want you to finish this game and test it out.
I'm Layla Monroe, folks. And today, my company, Elysian Fields Developments, is offering you a chance to own.
Must be his blind spot.
This great land for yourself. We're building sturdy, spacious houses.
800 square foot. It's just the dent, Jack. Your car will be fine.
Perfect for families looking to make a new life in a burgeoning city. Plus, I guarantee that our prices will put us
smaller.
So call us now.
Oh, I don't got a siren. I got a Hong Kong.
Hey, before I mute again, I got a question for you. What's your favorite, so far, what has been your favorite partner?
My favorite partner. Okay, well, the dick is obviously out of the picture.
Yeah, Roy is out. Mike Stefan. Traffic, Burkowski, I think that's...
Burkowski was good.
I work for California Fire and Life.
Rusty was okay, he just talked back too much.
Here? No, not here. The housing development over on Normandy Avenue. So? I found some lumber over there.
But you know, I like having no partner. I'm alone. I'm on my own.
Quite made the transition to talking. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund are pulling the place down. Know anything about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund? Nix. Mind if I take a look around? I'm kind of hungry. If someone was to leave a couple of bucks here, I might wander down the street. And
Jack.
Is there a key to the gate?
You little son of a bitch.
Go in or out are some delivery guys from Elysian Fields. They're working on a housing development over at Wilton and Santa Monica. You'll have to hop it.
You son of a bitch!
Just bribed an officer.
I know!
Not even an officer, a security guard.
I know, but it was slick.
This man said, I'm kinda hungry.
I mean, the officer was literally just asking for it at that point.
Stuck in this area.
Let's see what the rich and powerful have to say for
there's
themselves.
There's wood outside, fake wood, you gotta find that. But the main stuff is in this room.
What's in the case?
Is that a newspaper back there?
I'm pretty sure it's not a newspaper.
I wanna check.
Nope.
Definitely not that one. That's too fast.
That's not even English!
Might want to do the bottom part.
Great day for the future of Los Angeles. Civic leaders and businessmen join forces to launch the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund pledges to speed up housing development for returning GIs.
Gentlemen, this is Dr. Harlan Fontaine. He's our latest investor in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. Doctor, this is Curtis Benson.
Oh!
The California Fire and Life. Pleased to meet you, Doctor.
Ray Gordon, editor of the Times.
Doctor.
District Attorney Don Sandler and Police Chief.
It's him.
I am delighted to be in such exalted company.
You're making quite a name for yourself, Doctor, amongst the...
This is all started because of the frickin' morphine, bro.
Autistic temperament, often of a fragile mental disposition.
It's a short step from miscreant to recidivism, Doctor.
Because Courtney gave him the morphine and he used the funds from the morphine to start the... No.
Gentlemen, we're here to sell the American dream, and Hollywood is our greatest advertiser.
So, how is your new development selling, Leland?
Cannot throw them up fast enough, Ray.
And that's part of the problem, Leland. Washington is receiving steady complaints. There's a clamor for public
housing. God damn it, Ray. Public housing is tantamount to communism. Now that's why we fought this goddamn war. I'm telling you, it's Reds via the back door.
You can't have it both ways, Leland. The new freeways are being built to service all your developments out in the boondocks. They're all being built with government money.
The GI Bill is government money.
There's a difference.
What difference?
The GI money ends up in my pocket.
I hope you mean our pockets, Leland. We're all investors.
Of course, Curtis.
So, when will the freeway bond be passed on?
It still has to be ratified. It takes a long time to raise $3 billion.
I need to find a game well or a telephone.
Oh, he's busted.
In a great day for the future of Los Angeles, city leaders and business join forces to launch the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund pledges
to... I'm pretty sure it wasn't, because I tried clicking on it. See? Is there anything else in this room?
Not in the room, outside. There's wood, broken wood. You gotta find it.
I see a telephone. Come on, Jack, pump those legs.
On that side.
Oh, don't tell me I gotta go around this whole entire...
Yep.
No!
Yep, right there. It's in one of those, panels.
How come I don't hear music anymore?
Because you turned it off, right?
No, I don't hear the do do do.
Well, let me check for you. I'm pretty sure that's... Unless you did it on where the bulldozer is, that's where you did it, or no? You ever see some fake, like, cheap wood?
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure... Oh!
There.
What do we have here?
So this is where their lumber comes from?
Okay, so then where's the wood?
Hold on.
Here we are.
That's one way to keep your costs down. Too bad it won't support
what,
a roof.
What case is this called?
House of Sticks. Literally. Literally House of Sticks, because this is wood. I'm pretty sure that's everything. Yeah, that's everything.
That's everything?
Yep, things cross off. What the fuck was that? Alright, I gotta end the video and make another one. Hope y'all did enjoy. If you did, smash that like button to go see more of this. Be sure you subscribe to the channel with notifications on so you don't miss any new videos or uploads I do in the future. As always, I'll see you on the next video. Peace.